Hi, I'm Warren Poschman, a solutions architect at Comforte AG. So in talking to clients, I get a lot of similar questions from people that are really centered around, you know, hey, what do you see coming down the, you know, in the industry? You know, what's the next thing, you know, that, you know, that's going to hit me, you know, or, you know, what should I be worried about and stuff like that. And invariably, you know, they always want to know, well, really, what has drastically changed? You know, what is different from 10 years ago? And I think, honestly, by far, the biggest change is really on how we provide and share IT services. In 2010, virtualization was something that was a bit of a dream, trending technology that we occasionally used and wasn't necessarily even trusted. But, you know, 2020, we've moved past that. You know, everything's virtualized and we're actually moving through that into the cloud. And so really the emerging thing is really containerization and the emerging orchestration technologies. And so those, you know, it's interesting because those actually have changed how we think about technology and how we consume services. And it doesn't have to be a box. It doesn't have to be a discrete server anymore. And so with that, of course, there's new risks, new challenge, because there's an ever-increasing threat to security. So, you know, data is just as valuable as it was before, but, you know, with the advent of all of the new capabilities, it just makes that problem worse, unfortunately. So another thing folks like to ask is, you know, what should I be doing for the next 10 years? I want to have a 10-year plan, look ahead. And, you know, what should I be expecting, or, you know, what am I doing today that I won't be doing tomorrow, right? You know, I view this as the Internet of Things, IoT sort of, if you will, continues to proliferate. You know, so with that will be the volume of data. So we've got sensors, we've got devices, we've got, you know, virtualized, you know, machines that are creating data, taking data from us, you know, providing that feedback loop. And so with that, the threats that are going to be against that data is going to be also get more sophisticated, because it's not just the you know, the attackers are not just the ones that are going to continue to attack the same way. Their sophistication, and I think ultimately 10 years from now, our sense of privacy will be altered, an altered state, if you will. It won't be what we consider privacy today. And I believe actually, though, we can solve these problems. I mean, it's going to take some work, and it's going to require organizations to make some investments and do some hard work, as, you know, not just quick, easy solutions. So what sort of factors are typically important, you know, when I want to analyze or look at, you know, trends and evolving things? I think there's two different areas here. One, it's what's already emerging today. It's the things we know about today, the things that we see about today, you know, whether it's containerization and orchestration, or, you know, something to do with, you know, cloud-based resources. But it's something that we see today. And it's also, secondly, the problems that we have to solve already. So it's sort of, you know, the technologies that exist, the things that we can put our hands on, if you will, and the, you know, the problems that we know about already. And I think innovation primarily comes from a combination of those two things. It's I have a problem, I need to solve it, and the tools I have in front of me are, you know, not adequate, or they need to be better, or I need to use them in a different way. So I think ultimately that's how we solve problems, that's how we innovate. One thing that we're all worried about, obviously, is what's coming next or the future. And I think, you know, when I look at that, you know, there's really one thing that's the biggest concern. It's always that, you know, we're not going to learn, and ultimately we're going to repeat the, you know, those historical failures, right? So knowing what we do today about threats to our data, to our infrastructure, you know, we really need to, as it were, keep an eye on the ball so we can break that endless cycle of the breach. And so, you know, it's really, you know, the concern is that we don't learn. The concern is that we don't evolve. And I think that's the key, is we can't keep trying the same things over and over again. So we always like to look back and, you know, have hindsight being 2020 sort of thinking. And so when I do that, I think about, gee, if I'd only known this now, I could have done it so much better. And for me in IT security, it came down to that back in 2010, you know, the security trend for data security really focused around some technologies that we would today call data at rest encryption, you know, encrypting disks, storage arrays, you know, files, whatever it may be. And at the time, it seemed like a great way to, you know, secure data. You could, you know, take a whole disk, you could encrypt it. It's, you know, it's cheap, it's easy, it's fast. And ultimately, I think that success actually proved to be somewhat of a detriment, and undoing that thinking really is exponentially hard, sort of like breaking an addiction. You know, once you're addicted, it's hard to get off of it. And so I think that I wish I had seen that ease of use, that kind of turn it on and I feel protected. You know, that false sense of security that we've seen today, that it doesn't really protect you. I wish I'd seen that. And, you know, it took a really tough client of mine that basically said, why am I doing this? This doesn't do anything for me. And at the time, I didn't want to believe it, but ultimately he was right. You know, I'm spending money on something that's not protecting me. Even though I feel protected, I'm not. With the ever increasing amount of breaches, I get often asked, you know, like in the next decade, you know, how is the threat going to change? How is technology going to change? Is it going to hurt me, you know, or will I be better off, right? And so, look, I'm not going to predict a sort of Hollywood dystopian, you know, sort of rise of the machines a la Cyberdyne or something like this. But I definitely can see a realization of independent decision making and sort of a true AI that goes beyond the what I would call quasi-AI that we have today with digital assistants and other, you know, intelligent services. I wouldn't be surprised to see IT capabilities being provided in a more dynamic way that kind of requires less human orchestration. In other words, so if you will, machines orchestrating other machines. And so I think that, you know, we're going to have some computing resources designing, implementing other compute resources. That's something that's going to be different. And we'll still be part of it. I don't think people will be less part of it. And I think that the threat vectors, the attacks, are going to be just as personal as they are today. They just might be more persistent. They might be more, you know, resilient to some of the traditional security measures and, you know, be able to get through that, sort of like a virus that evolves. And I think that, you know, we might see something that we can use as part of, you know, those innovations in the way we control technology and how technology builds other technology, if you will. And I think that we can harness that and make more productivity and make technology really accessible to more people than we ever have.